Well, good afternoon students, welcome back to online mathematics class. So in the last class we have solved up to the 18th problem. So in today's class let us continue with the 19th question. It is show that integral 0 to a f of x into g of x dx which is equals to 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx if f and g are defined. So as f of x equal to f of a minus x and g of x plus g of a minus x equal to 4. So I'll be taking this as I. So here I which is equals to integral 0 to a f of x into g of x dx. So I call this as equation number 1. Then by using P4, I is equals to integral 0 to a f of a minus x into g of a minus x dx. Then, so here, what is f of a minus x? F of a minus x is going to be f of x. So here, I which is equals to integral 0 to a. So here in place of f of a minus x, I can write f of x into g of a minus x dx. So I call this as equation number 2. Now we will have to go for adding equation 1 and equation 2. So adding 1 and 2. So here I plus I will be 2i. So now 2i which is equals to integral 0 to a. Now we will have to add these two integrand. So here f of x is going to be common. We get f of x g of x plus f of x into g of a minus x. So now if we add these two, we get f of x into g of x plus f of x into g of a minus x dx. So here I take f of x common, 2i which is equals to integral 0 to a, then take f of x common, then what do we get? Here we get g of x plus g of a minus x dx. So what is f g of x plus g of a minus x? It is going to be 4. So 2i is equals to integral 0 to a, we get f of x into 4 dx. So now 2 1s are here, we get 2 2s are. So I which is equals to 2, I'll be writing it outside as it is a constant. Then 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx. So this is the required answer for the 19th question. So the 20th problem, it is the value of integral minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 x cube plus x cos x plus tan raised to 5x plus 1 dx is, and the four options are 0, 2, pi, 1. So here, see the limits, it is minus a to plus a. That means we have to make use of the last property, that is P7. We have to check whether it is an even function or an odd function. So I'll be taking this as I. So here I which is equals to integral minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, then x cube plus x cos x plus tan raised to 5x plus 1 dx plus 1 dx. So integrate them separately now. So I is equals to minus pi by 2 2 plus pi by 2, then we get x cube dx plus integral minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, we get x cos x dx plus integral minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 tan to the power 5 x dx plus integral minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 1 dx. So here if you go for f of minus x, so we get minus f of x now, because all these are odd functions. So whenever you have an odd function, then the value of the integral is going to be 0. See here, I'll show you one example. So take this as f of x. Then now to check even or odd function, we have to replace x by minus x. We get f of minus x, sorry, x cube. And then here we get minus x cube. Minus x cube is nothing but minus of x cube. So here f of x is f of minus x equal to, so I replace this x cube by f of x. What did you get now? F of minus x equal to minus f of x. That means it is an odd function. So here similarly you will get this as an odd function. So here also tan raised to 5x, again we get an odd function, whereas this is going to be an even function. Then if it is an even function, why it is an even function? See here, f of x is equals to 1. Now f of minus x, so here we don't have an x term, that means we write 1 as it is. So f of minus x is equals to, what is 1 now? 1 is nothing but f of x. So even after changing x by minus x, we are still getting the same function. That is why this is an even function. If it is an even function, then the given integral reduces to integral minus a to a f of x dx is equals to 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx. If f of x is an even function, if it is an odd function, then the value of the integral becomes 0. So we have to make use of this particular concept. So here I, which is equals to 0 plus 0 plus 0, because all these three are odd functions, plus 2 times integral 0 to a, it is 0 to pi by 2 1 dx. Now we will have to evaluate only this particular integral. I which is equals to 2 times, then what is the integration of 1 here? It is x, and then apply the limit 0 to pi by 2. Then I is equals to 2 times upper limit minus the lower limit. We get pi by 2 minus 0, that is pi by 2. So here 2 get cancels, we get I is equals to pi. We have got I equal to pi. So it is the option C. This is all about the 20th problem. Well, the 21st problem, it is the value of integral 0 to pi by 2 log 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x dx is, the four options are 2, 3 by 4, 0, and then minus 2. So I'll be taking this as I which is equals to, I is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, then log 4 plus 3 sin x, 4 plus 3 sin x, then divided by 4 plus 3 cos x dx. So now call this as equation number 1. So now we have to make use of the property P4. So let us make use of the property P4 here by using P4, then I, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 log So here x changes to a minus x. What is the value of a? It is pi by 2. So log 4 plus 3 sine, we get pi by 2 minus x. Pi by 2 minus x, then whole divided by 4 plus 3 cos pi by 2 minus x, we get dx. So now in the next step we get I, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, then log log 4 plus 3 sine 90 minus x will be cos x, then divided by 4 plus 3 times cos 90 minus x is equals to sin x dx. So I call this as equation number 2. Now we will have to go for adding 1 and 2. So adding 1 and 2, I plus I will be 2i, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, we get this term plus the second term, log log 4 plus 3 sin x, 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x, then plus log we have to write this term now, 4 plus 3 cos x, 4 plus 3 cos x divided by 4 plus 3 sin x, close the bracket and then close the mean bracket now, then write dx. Now here, one second, so now it is in the form of log x plus log y. Log x plus log y can be written as log xy. So here 2i, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, we get log xy. These two will be multiplied. So what do we get now? 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x into, so we get 4 plus 3 cos x divided by 4 plus 3 sin x dx. So now 4 plus 3 sin x and 4 plus 3 sin x get cancels. These two terms get cancels. Then 4 plus 3 cos x and 4 plus 3 cos x get cancels. 2i, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2, we get log 1 dx. What is the value of log 1? It is 0. Integral of 0 will be 0. We get 2i is equals to 0. This implies I is equals to 0. We have got the required answer. Now search for the option. So the right answer is the option C. So with this, we have completed the 21st problem as well as the exercise 7.11 as well as the chapter integration.